Hi students, this is your Jam Simon. In this video we are going to discuss why F block element general electronic configuration is N-2 F1 to 14 N-1 D 0 or 1 NSZ2. In this video I am not going to in depth. Here just how F block elements got this general electronic configuration. Only this part I am explaining. I am not going to in detail of the electronic configurations of all F block elements. Why? Because in the F block elements electronic configuration, so many exceptions will come. This F block elements will show the different electronic configurations. So because of that, I am not going to discuss about the all electronic configurations of F block elements. So here first we'll see students our electronic configurations of F block elements. All the elements in there anti-penultimate shell. So this is the representation for anti-penultimate shell. This is N-2. So in their anti-penultimate shell, in F orbital, how many electrons may present? It may be from 1 to 14. So in anti-penultimate shell of F orbital, 1 to 14 electrons may present. And in penultimate shell, N-1 is the penultimate shell. In the penultimate shell of d orbital, the number of electrons are either 0 or 1. Similarly, in the valence shell, n is the representation for valence shell, right? So, in this valence shell of s orbital, 2 electrons will present. 2 electrons are present. So, this is the general electronic configuration for all f block elements. So, in anti-penultimate shell, f orbital 1 to 14 electrons. In penultimate shell, d orbital, it may have 1 electron or no electrons. Okay, students, here don't confuse. Here, not compulsory in penultimate shell of d orbital, electron should be no. The electrons may not be. Okay, if there, that is only 1 electron may present in penultimate shell of d orbital. Clear, students, here? Next, in the valence shell of s orbital, 2 electrons are present. So, this is the general electronic configuration for all F block elements. Here I am taking 2 elements to make you understand this topic some more better. See here students, these are the 2 elements I have taken. This is neodymium, this is uranium. So here neodymium is the 4s series element, one I have taken, and uranium is the 5s series element. This from 5s I have taken one. So 4f is 1, 5f series is 1 element I have taken to explain this topic. Okay, see here, this is the electronic configuration for neodymium and this is the electronic configuration for uranium. Now if you observe, it is having the electronic configuration according to Mohler's diagram or increasing order of energy. So 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, after 4s. So according to increasing order it came. Okay, once you please check. Now for these 2 elements, I am writing the electronic configuration according to shell wise. Now it is there according to increasing order of energy, right? Now I am going to write the electronic configuration according to shell wise to make you understand better. See here students, I have written the electronic configurations according to shell wise. Once you please see here, first shell, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. So according to shell wise, I have written the electronic configuration here. So here also same like that only, I have written the electronic configurations. So according to increasing order of the shell, not according to increasing order of the energy. Okay, this according to shell wise, I have written the electronic configurations. Now you please observe here, this is 4th shell, this is 5th shell, this is 6th shell. So this is the valence shell, means last shell. So this is the representation is N, right? In S, how many electrons are there? 2 electrons are there. 2 electrons are there. This is now 5s to 5p. This is the 5th shell. So to the 6, 5 is the before, right? So this is the penultimate shell. So what is the penultimate shell representation? N-1. N-1. 5s to 5p, 6. Here no changes will come. Now can you please observe here, 5d orbital is not there. Why? Because in this no electrons. No electrons is nothing but 0 electrons are there. Clear, students? So in the penultimate shell of d orbital, no electrons. So here it is 0. So n minus 1 d, 0 for this element. Okay. Next, come to the next, this fourth series, means fourth shell. 4s2, 4p6, 4d10, 4f4, 4. Now, 6 is the valence shell. 5 is before, so it is penultimate shell. Next, 4 is before to penultimate shell, right? So, this is anti-penultimate shell. What is the representation for anti-penultimate shell? It is n minus 2. In which orbital there is a variation, means in f4. Series it will come, means in all the 4f series elements till here the electronic configuration is same. Here where I have represent with the orange color, right? So with orange ink I have represented, in this only changes will come. Okay, in 4f series, so till 4d10 it is common. In 4f the electrons number will change. Similarly in the fifth shell, in 5d orbital the electrons number will change, it may be 0 or 1. Similarly, in valence shell, it is 2 in all cases. Okay, students? So, in F, how many electrons are there? 4 electrons are there. So, N minus 2, F 4. N minus 1, D 0, NS 2. So, in simple form, we can represent like this also for neodymium. Next, come to the uranium. Now, see, this is the valence shell. How many electrons are there? 2 electrons. In which orbital? It is S orbital. So, 7th is the valence shell, right? So here 7th is the valence shell, right? So valence shell representation is N. How many electrons? 2 electrons in the S orbital. So NS 2. Next, come to the penultimate shell. So this is 6th in this case. Here the electrons variation is there in the 6D orbital. So how many electrons are there? It in this uranium case, 1 electron is there in 6D orbital. So 6th is the penultimate shell, right? So representation is N minus 1. In which orbital? D orbital. How many electrons? 1 electron. Come to the antipenultimate shell. So here 5th shell is the antipenultimate shell. Where there is a variation of electrons? In this 5f orbital, electrons variation will come. Okay. So for antipenultimate shell, N minus 2 is the representation. In f orbital, 3 electrons are present. Okay. Once we will write together, students. See here. In antipenultimate shell, actually here 3 or 4, 2 examples we have taken. So, in one orbital, 3 electrons are there. In another orbital, 4 electrons are there. But overall in F orbital, what is the capacity? 1 to 14. So, from 1 to 14, the number of electrons may present in the F orbital. So, here 1 to 14. How many number of electrons may present in F orbital? That may be from 1 to 14. Next, in penultimate shell, how many electrons may present? Either 0 or 1. Either 0 or 1. You can write here in between, or you can write, or small hyphen also we can put. Okay, these three methods are correct only. Next, in valence shell, how many electrons? 2 electrons are present. Clear, students? Now, in antipenultimate shell of F orbital, the electrons number may be present from 1 to 14. In penultimate shell of D orbital, the electrons may not present, means it may be 0. If there, means that is only 1 electron may be present. Okay, students? That is, to get the stability, electrons will transfer. We are not going to that much in detail in this video. Okay, next, in valence shell, 2 electrons are present. So, this is the general electronic configuration for all F block elements. Now I hope you understand why F block element general electronic configuration is N minus 2 F 1 to 14, N minus 1 D 0 or 1 NS 2. How it got. I hope you like this video and you feel this is useful. Thank you.